This week we're talking about Pasifika teenagers and gambling. A Ministry of Health funded research has shown some interesting findings about the gambling habits of Pasifika youth and their mums.
Well, joining us now is the director of the Pacific Islands Family Study at the Auckland University of Technology, Dr El-Shadan Tautolo. Welcome.
Morning.
I listen for you.
What were some of the key findings that came out of the research?
So basically we interviewed about approximately 950 Pacific mothers and their children, and we found that about half of them were actually gambling. And that's also with the young kids as well. And I think probably most concerning was that a small proportion of them were actually problem gamblers too. So that was quite concerning.
Why are they gambling?
In terms of risk factors which we found for the youth, things like involvement with gangs or gang affiliation, or also being a victim of bullying at school, made them more susceptible to gambling, as well as also having a mother who was a gambler too.
Okay, so for the teenagers, what type of gambling are they getting involved in? Is it online or...?
Most of them were actually gambling with family and friends, so again, touching on that, you know, influence of peers and also adult people. They'd gamble on things like cards, playing cards, bingo, even marbles, yeah.
Wow.
What are the risk factors?
Those things around gang involvement, being a victim of bullying. Mm. But also I think, you know, when we spoke with the mums, there was this whole risk around deprivation coming from, you know, a low deprivation sort of situation. There's a real sort of intergenerational link that's happening there, where the gambling of the mums is influencing the gambling of their young people.
Yeah. I'm thinking a lot, even within my own community, you know, a lot of the mums, aunties and nannas, they're going, you know, doing the community fundraising once a week or twice a week. The kids probably watching on and they're there as well. How worried are you about those types of activities happening in our community?
It is a real worry, and I guess coming back to the kids, you know, they're only 14, so this is kind of setting them up for behaviours which can have real consequences later on in life. So it's definitely something to keep keep an eye on.
What about bingo? That's quite a big a community event in our community here. What is that classed as?
I guess it is a form of gambling. One of the things that did come out amongst the young people was a worrying proportion were actually spending a lot of money per week on gambling.
How much did they spend?
You had about a third that were spending $10 or less per week.
Wow.
But also a worrying proportion that were spending $20 or more, which when you look at that over, you know, a period of a year, that's quite a lot of money for kids that come from, you know, households which don't have a lot of money to spend.
Do you think there's some kind of complacency within our community, perhaps with our mums or our families, that, you know, oh, we're just playing cards or we're just going to bingo, not thinking about the effect of our teenagers or the kids watching?
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, we need to be aware as adults and parents of the influence that we can have on our young people, and just be mindful that, yeah, you know, they are watching, so... Yeah.
Where can people go for help, or if your teenager may have an issue with gambling? Or...
There's gambling helplines that you can approach, but, I think there just needs to be a comprehensive approach in terms of addressing these issues for our Pacific families.
In terms
families.
Of policy and a wide approach as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, thank you very much for coming on the show today, and we will have some links as well on our Facebook page as well.
Malo pito tēnā.